skeletal system functions, looking at the main different functions of the system. The first one is the attachment of muscle. So the reason we need the skeleton is to attach muscle, to allow us to have tendons, joints, ligaments, things like that, to be able to move the body about. The skeleton is also a support network, so this helps us to keep our posture, and bears the weight of the rest of the body as well. It protects vital organs like the brain, the lungs, the heart, specifically the rib cage and the cranium. Movement, so the muscles work in terms of contracting, and they will pull all of the bones and work them as levers. And blood cell production inside our bones, as we've already covered, we've got the medullary cavity, and that helps to build bone marrow. And then lastly, mineral storage, which we covered as well. So we've got things like calcium, phosphorus, that are stored in the bone marrow. Looking at major bones, we'll just whiz through this quickly, because you can pause and play as you feel fit to help you revise. So we've got all of them there from top to bottom. You'll notice in blue are the ones that are related to the axial skeleton. And these are the main ones that cover protection of the major organs. And these are the main central core of the body. Don't give us much movement at all, really. The rest of them in green are appendicular, so we're covering everything from your clavicle, collarbone, humerus, ulna radius. And we kind of covered that a little bit in terms of if you've got your thumbs up, your little finger is underneath, so little finger under is ulna, as a way to remember it. You've got your pubis and your ischium, as well as your ilium, and they form the pelvis there. Your patella, the kneecap, and then working our way down to things like the heel bone, all make up the front part of the skeleton. Looking at the back, we've got the scapula, as well as the vertebral column, again green and blue to support appendicular and axial skeleton. And then in the hands and feet, we are looking at carpals, metacarpals. Now the carpals are in the wrist. They are in the wrist area, whereas the metacarpals form the palm of the hand, which can be felt if you manipulate around the palm. With the feet, you've got your calcaneus, your heel bone, then your tarsals, which form the lower part of the ankle, and then your metatarsals, which make up the main bridge of the foot. And your phalanges are simply your fingers and toes, just small bones, classified as long bones, but they are small bones. Onto your vertebral column, if we look at the five different sections in there, you've got 33 irregular shaped bones, and there's a bit of cartilage in between each one, and that allows smooth movement, as well as a little bit of pressure compression to take the weight off. We protect the spinal cord as well, and our nerve, main nerve, the spinal cord, will run right down the middle of this, and branch out through these little holes here to various parts of the body to allow us to have electrical activity and move. It has got an irregular shape, but this aids for muscle attachment, hence these strange formations on the back of the spine. This helps with muscle attachment. So you've got your cervical, makes up your seven bones, and this has got an inward concave way of doing it. And this is all really, that will bear at quite a lot of the weight of the skull. Then you've got your thoracic section, the largest part of the spine. 12 bones that get larger the further down you go. And they can convex outwards. And this allows us to bend forward and things like that. But it also has this here, because that's where the heart would be, just in front of that curve. Look at the lumbar then, the five largest parts of the vertebra. These are good for holding the rest of the weight above it, really. Attaches many muscles around that lower back area, including areas of the core. Then you've got your sacrum, which are five bones that have been fused together through fixed joints. And then it's down to your coccyx, which are four, again, fused bones right on the tail there.